How are you guys doing? All right, who likes dinosaurs? All right, well, that was my show. Goodbye. When I was little, my favorite thing in the world to do was to go to the library and read books about
dinosaurs.
No motorcycles. What is wrong with you people? Yes, that's what I read about. Almost everything I learned about dinosaurs, I learned from reading books. How many of you are signed up for the summer reading program? I am so proud of you. You know what's even more proud? All of you parents that spend so much time encouraging your kids to do that. It is incredible. I speak at libraries all over the state. I've got to tell you something. This library, and I'm not saying this because I'm here, I'm saying this sincerely. This library is run by some of the kindest, most courteous people I work with. And the guys that work back there in the booth are the guys that handle the lights and the sound. They're always incredibly professional. Your librarian is one of the nicest people I know. Everybody here. But it's so good that you guys do much, so much for your kids to encourage education. So you guys are amazing, and I love coming to this library. All right, time to learn about dinosaurs. Before we do, there are three rules I want you to follow. Rule number one, stay in your seat. Rule number two, I don't want you to just yell out, look at me, I'm sitting right here. And rule number three, don't talk to your neighbor.
OMG, did you hear what he said?
Before we talk about dinosaurs, there were other animals that used to live right here that were not dinosaurs. By raising our hand, who can tell me an animal that lived a long time ago, but it's not a dinosaur? This is hard. Tell me one. Which one? Quetzalcoatlus. Good boy, that's a perfect one. Tell me one. A saber-toothed cat, atta boy. Tell me one. A mammal. Yes, mammals. Good boy. Tell me one, sweetie. A shark, atta girl. Tell me one, honey. A fish, good girl. Tell me one. My grandfather. What? Mammoth is right. Let's start with that. This is a woolly mammoth. Can you guys say that?
Woolly.
Hey, you're pretty good. I'll give you a harder one. I bet you won't say this one. Coelophysis. I'll give you a harder one. You're not going to say this one. Compsognathus. You little weasels. All right. I'll give you some that are so hard, there's no way you're saying these. Eunotherium. Eudemorphodon. Euoplocephalus. Eustreptospondylus. You stinking kids are driving me nuts, Thesaurus. You smell like a skunkosaurus. What? Listen, it was hot out there. I'm sweaty, all right? Mammoths are elephants that were very, very big, bigger than elephants today, much bigger than elephants today. They were so giant. Check this out. This is one tooth from a woolly mammoth. Its tooth is as big as your head. I had a little girl out of school ask me, Dinosaur George, do they put the tooth under the pillow? Can you imagine if you walked up to your mom? Hey, mom, my tooth fell out. Yeah, last night it was loose, so dad tied a chain around it, pulled it out with a truck. If you put that under your pillow, the tooth fairy would sneak into your house and walk up to your bed and lift up your pillow. You gotta be kidding me. Now, these elephants were big. They were giant. But other animals that lived here weren't big. Not everything was big. How many of you, and I know most of you have, how many of you have ever seen a horse before? Of course you've seen a horse. There was a horse named Mesohippus. Can you say that? I'm going to show you the skull of a full-grown one. This is amazing. This is how big that horse was. That is not a baby horse. You are looking at the head of a full... You... You are looking at... What are you laughing at? What? What? He's looking at me? Ah! All right, you better stop with the jokes right now. This horse was only that tall. That is as big as that horse would ever be. It is hard to believe that tiny little horses used to live here, but they did. There was another animal that lived here that might surprise you. How many of you have a dog at home? Who's got a dog at your house? You got a dog? And you have to excuse me for coughing. Allergies have been killing me this week. There was a dog named Hesperocyon. Can you say it?
Hesperocyon.
This is the world's first dog. Now, he's going to be a little big, and he's going to be a little scary. Take a deep breath in. Breathe out. Now, if you are scared, you don't want to look at him because he scares me. Take a look at this. Doink. That is not a baby dog. That is a full-grown Hesperocyon. That's as big as he's ever going to be. Now, he's kind of cool because he has a long, skinny body, not like a wiener dog, more like a ferret. He has a long, skinny body, and he's fast, and you know what? We believe they could climb trees as fast as a squirrel. They had to get away from the naughty meat eaters. Can you imagine if your dog could climb a tree like a squirrel? You would come home from school and your mom would be like, honey, I've got bad news. I think your dog ran away because he's not in the backyard. And you walk in the backyard, no, my dog, I miss it. What are you doing up there? He's at the top of a tree. This is awesome! I can see my house from here. You can see your house from down here, too. Now, this tiny dog could climb because there were some naughty animals that would have tried to eat him. One of those animals was a cat. A cat named Eusmilus. Can you say it? Here is the head of a Eusmilus. Now, he's big. He's about the size of a bobcat. He's bigger than your house cat, but he's very naughty. If you tried to pet him, he's got a very scary surprise. Take a look at his teeth. Look at the chompers on that cat. Here's what's cool. You see the way his jaw hangs down like that? It does that so that when he could, wouldn't that be cool if you could take your head off like that? If you were talking too much at home, your mom could take your head. Give me that! This kid hadn't stopped talking since he was born. Mama needs a break once in a while. When this cat closes his mouth, his teeth fit right there, and then his cheeks cover them. You didn't know they were there. You couldn't see them. So if you looked at him, you'd think, oh, he's so cute. What is he going to do to me? Meow. Ooh. Ooh. He's going to eat me. That's great. Now I'm going to show you another animal, and this next animal is going to trick you because I'm going to ask you to guess what it is. This time, you don't have to raise your hand. You can yell it out, and I'll see if I can hear it. Let me tell you this. This animal I'm going to show you is not a dinosaur, and it's not a cat. Not a dinosaur, not a cat. What do you think this thing is? A shark, it's not a saber tooth, but that's a good guess. A dog is a good guess. A walrus is a good guess. That's a good guess. Let me give you a hint. His cousins are alive in Australia today. It's a cousin of a kangaroo. This nasty looking critter is a marsupial, meaning he's a cousin of a kangaroo. Even though it had giant teeth, marsupials today, some are meat eaters, some are meat eaters. This guy definitely was. He's very big, he's very fast, he's very powerful. Now, this guy is a naughty animal. I completely forgot his name. Chip, what is his name? Thank you. Thylacosmilus. By the way, everybody, that's Jurassic Chip, my assistant. Everybody say hey to Chip. Chip can't come up and do the show with me because he lost his voice as bad as I did. We flipped a coin. Ha ha! I lost. Now, these giant teeth were big and powerful, making this a very naughty animal. But there was another animal that lived in Texas. How many of you have ever been to Texas? A couple of you? Good. Excellent. Good. Good. I love it. I love it. Excellent. We're not in Texas. What? Oh! Well, I didn't look at my GPS very closely. I don't know. There was a giant bird named Forus Roccus. Can you say it?
Forus Roccus.
This is the head of that naughty killer bird. Now, this bird does not fly. He can't fly. He's got little tiny wings, but he runs very quickly. This bird ate those horses I just showed you. And if this bird was in this room right now, his head would be about this tall from down there at the floor. He's fast and he's strong, but this is not the biggest, naughtiest bird. There was another bird that used to live in Australia. Its name was Dromornis. Can you say that?
Dromornis.
Here is the head of that giant killer bird. This is a bird that if he was standing down there with you guys, his head would be this tall. This is a giant bird. This is the ugliest chicken that ever lived. He would have eaten Colonel Sanders. This giant bird was huge, and he lived a long time ago, but he's not a dinosaur. None of the things I showed you were dinosaurs. Now, let's go farther back in time, and let's look at dinosaurs. Let me ask you something, my little scientists. Were all dinosaurs big? No, there were little dinosaurs. I'm going to show you a little dinosaur. This guy's kind of cool. All right, no laughing when I show you his little head. No laughing when I show. No laughing. All right, here we go. Take a look. No laughing. All right, here we go. Take a look. Don't laugh. Here we go. Take a look at. Don't laugh when I turn around, by the way. Nobody laughs. Nobody. All right, here we go. Doink. What kind of kids are you? You're the naughtiest kids I've ever seen. Stinking kids. I'm practicing when I become really old. This is a dinosaur named Eoraptor. Can you say that?
Eoraptor.
Now, he's little. He's very small, but it doesn't mean he's not dangerous. He's got very, very sharp teeth, and that means he ate meat. He ate meat. He ate fish. He ate waffles. What? Waffles? 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 Alright, I'm sorry. Let me try that again. He ate meat, he ate fish, he ate spaghetti, Spaghetti. Spaghetti? Spaghetti. Now he's very little. He was only about that tall, but you know what? There was a dinosaur even smaller than this. Take a look at. No laughing this time. I better not hear one laugh. Here we go. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, dun, dun, da! What kind of kids are you? This is not a baby dinosaur. I know he's little. I know he's tiny. This is the full-grown dinosaur named Microraptor. Can you say it? You know the most amazing thing? He is so little, full-grown. He was about that tall. He is so little, you could put him in your backpack and sneak him into school on the first day. You could be sitting in class, and you got a dinosaur in your backpack. You're like, ha, ha, ha. Then he jumps out, and he runs across the desk and steals some kid's pencil. Teacher, his chicken just took my pencil. He's little, he's fast, and he's smart. So some dinosaurs were tiny. Now some were absolutely giant. These are the biggest kinds of dinosaurs that ever lived. One of these we nickname a long neck, and one of these we nickname a whip tail. Point to the one you think was the whip-tailed dinosaur. Oh, you are good. You are good. We call it a whip tail because his tail is long and stiff. And if somebody tried to sneak up and take a bite out of this dinosaur, it would bend that tail back. Just think of your mom had a tail like that. If your mother had a tail like this, she could get you kids from three blocks away. You'd be outside playing, your mom would come out. Kids, it's time to come home. Kids, I said come home. Don't make me use my tail. You look up, mama's tail, run! I had to send that kid to the moon. You know what's amazing about these long necks is how little the babies were when they hatched. You know, when I was little, if somebody asked me how big their egg would be, my guess would be about that big, because that's what I would think. But actually, the eggs are much smaller than we think, and there's a reason why. See, if the egg was as big as we think it should be, the egg shell would have to be very, very thick. Otherwise, the egg would crack when it hits the ground. So if the egg shell was thick, that means the baby inside would never have the strength to ever get out of the egg. So instead, their babies are small, but they grow very quickly. Here's an egg of a long-necked dinosaur. See how big that is? Inside, I have the model. For you little guys, that means a toy of what a little baby might have looked like. Look, he can come out. Come out of there, mister. Come out of there, I said. The baby was so little, you could hold it in the palm of your hand. Let me show you how big mom and dad were so you have an understanding of size. That's the baby. This is its mom's pinky fingernail. Mom's fingernail is bigger than the baby. Can you imagine if you were born smaller than your mom's pinky nail? You guys would have been that big. Your mom would have come home from the hospital, all the family's there. Where's your baby? She's like, I don't know, I put that kid down somewhere. Your dad would take you to work to show his friends, hey, everybody, say hello to my son. Check this out. You want to see something amazing? My kid can do a flip. This is the coolest thing in the world. You ready? This is awesome. Ready? On three. One, two, three. He did it. Give that kid a... The number one thing babies had to worry about was being stepped on by mom or dad. That was the number one thing. See, predators would have kept their distance because mom or dad may have stayed and protected them. So the predator stayed away, but if you were a baby, the number one thing you better look for is where is mom stepping? Because dad comes home from work, he's like, I'm home! All right, that kid's name is Pancakeosaurus. Those dinosaurs were so big, nobody messed with them because they're too big. Some dinosaurs needed a way to be able to protect themselves. What is his name? Wrong, his name is Carl. Everybody say hey to Carl. Yes, it's Stegosaurus. And what do we call these things on his back? Plates, you guys are good. Here is the plate from a Stegosaurus. In Lubbock, Texas, that's a belt buckle. That's a time delay joke. In 20 years, you kids are going to die laughing at what I just said. Up there. You're going to be driving down the road. Remember that dinosaur guy in Lubbock? Belt buckle. When I was little, the books that I read told me these were weapons. They were used for protection. But new discoveries show us that's not right. These are actually used to help the dinosaur cool down when he's hot or warm up when he's cold. They are kind of like solar panels. Here's how they worked. If it woke up in the morning and he was cold, or she, They would look in the sky to find old Mr. Sun. And when they saw the sun, they turned their bodies sideways and let the sun shine on the plates. And the plates would become, and that would warm them up. If they were hot and they wanted to cool down, they would simply step under the shade of a tree and the plates would begin to get, and that's how they cooled down. See, here's why this is not a weapon. Look how thin and skinny this thing actually is. You see that? This is so skinny, this would be the worst weapon in the world. Because if a meat-eating dinosaur bit into this, this would crunch like a potato chip. Would you want to protect yourself with a potato chip? Can you imagine if you went to the zoo with your family and somebody walked up and said, "Run for your life, a lion got loose." You're like, "Mom, Dad, stand back. I've got a potato chip."
What?
The lion would come around the corner and see you. You're like, "Hello, Mr. Cat." The lion screams, "That kid's got a chip, run!" I have saved the family with the potato chip of doom. So if Stegosaurus didn't use its plate for protection, what did it use? The spikes on the tail. Here is the spike from its tail. This is a very, very good weapon. If this dinosaur didn't like you, it would swing that tail. Hello. The first words a dinosaur ever said was, "Owie, owie, 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 owie." There was four of these on its tail. Now, this doesn't look very sharp, but when this dinosaur was alive, there was actually a covering that fit over this. The covering is made of the same stuff our fingernails are made of. And so the covering made it longer and sharper, and that was a very good weapon. But there was another dinosaur that had an even better weapon. What is his name? Very good. It's Triceratops. Can you say it? For all of you parents, this is something I've been telling for years, but it is so funny, I simply have to share this with you. About 6 or 7 years ago, we were in Arlington speaking at an elementary school, and the elementary teachers came in, and one of them said, "Listen, we have a little group of pre-Ks. Would you come talk to them in their classroom?" I said, "Sure, I don't mind." So I walked in, and it was a little pre-Ks, the little Shrimposaurus kids. So I took this in, and I said, "Does anybody know his name?" And this tiny little boy screamed, "Try Tater Tots!" Tater Tots. Well, it got better than that. After that kid yelled, "Try Tater Tots," I thought I was going to die, right? So he was sitting next to a little girl, and at the end of the show, this little girl said, "Why did the dinosaurs die?" I said, "Honey, nobody knows for sure. We don't know." I said, "Do you have a guess?" She said, "I think it was one of those big ocean waves and that little Try Tater Tots boy." Turns to that girl with the most condescending look and goes, "That's called a salami." So what killed the dinosaurs? Bad breath. What does Try Tater Tot? Stop laughing, you kid. What does Triceratops use for protection? Here is the horn from a baby Triceratops. I knew it was a baby because when we dug it up, it was wearing a diaper. Now this... What? Wearing a diaper? This is from a baby. Moms and dads, their horns were much bigger. These things were big animals. They were very big. And these horns also, just like the one I told you, there was a covering that fit over this that made it much sharper and much longer. It was the keratin, the fingernail covering. Now, this is a very, very good weapon. But there was one dinosaur that didn't have weapons at all. The only thing it could do would be to get on a motorcycle and get out of there. Run. Their group name is called duckbills. Can you say that word?
Duckbills.
But this dinosaur's name is Myasora. Can you say that?
Myasora.
Here is the head of a baby Mayasaura. Why do we call it a duck bill? It has a flat beak like a duck. Now, that doesn't mean this is a giant duck. It didn't live in the water. If he was alive, he wouldn't walk up to you. Quack! This baby was small. All right, we're going to do something. I know it's going to be almost impossible, but we're going to try. I want you to try to look at its mouth. I know you won't be able to see in there, but we'll give it a shot. I want you to look inside of its mouth right here, and we're going to play a guessing game. This is going to be a hard guessing game. I know you won't be able to see in there, but here we go. How many teeth do you think a baby duckbill had?
Zero.
Zero? You're close. One? You're closer.
Two.
Closer?
Closer?
Closer? Closer? He had 2,000. This little dinosaur had 2,000 teeth, but they're tiny, and they're all back here in the back. There's none in the front. There's row after row after row, one on top of another, on top of another. They were tiny, and all their teeth were back here in the back. Now, these dinosaurs could only run, but there's one more plant eater that didn't have to worry about anything because it was so well protected. It was incredible. How many of you have ever seen a picture of a dragon? Have you ever seen a dragon before? Remember, dragons are pretend animals. They're not real. Dragons are not real animals. They're pretend. But the people in China that came up with the idea of dragons, they did that thousands of years ago because they saw something that in their mind, they came up with the idea of a dragon. Well, I happen to have a dinosaur that was discovered in China not too long ago. Its name is Cycania. Can you say that?
Cycania.
But his nickname is the dragon. Why do you think we call him the dragon? Isn't that amazing? So think about it. People in China 2,000 years ago may have seen things like this in the ground, and their imagination, it became a dragon. When people first in Europe first saw dinosaurs, they didn't know what they were. They took a guess, and they were wrong. So it could be possible that dragons exist because of animals like this. You know, if you ever watch during the Chinese New Year, you see those dancers in the street wearing the big dragon head, and they're all dancing. It looks a lot like these things. Now, this guy is so well protected, nobody could hurt him. See the little bumps on his head? Those are solid bone. If you tried to poke him in the head, my finger. His eyelids were not made of skin like ours. His were made of bone. When he closed his eye, it's like closing a door. My finger. His lips were not soft and kissable like ours. His lips were made of bone. If you tried to poke him in the mouth, my finger. Even his nose was protected by bone. If you tried to poke him in the nose, what are you laughing at? Here, everybody have some. There you go. All right. The dinosaurs I just showed you were plant eaters. Now let's learn about the meat-eating dinosaurs. How many of you like the meat eaters? Well, good. I got good news for you. The meat eaters would have liked all of you, too. They came in all different sizes, but one family was considered the most deadly. Those were the raptors. Raptors were more deadly than even giant T-Rex because raptors were smart and fast. They lived in groups. They also had incredible weapons. Let me show you. This is the foot of a typical meat-eating dinosaur. It's a little one, but that's the way meat-eaters' feet look. They have three long toes. They actually have five toes. One, two, three, four, five. But when they walk through the mud, they only leave three toe prints. That's why sometimes we think T-Rex only has three toes, because in books you see pictures of footprints and it always shows three. Well, the other toes are just too short to reach the dirt. That's why we only see three. Now, these three toes are what meat eaters use. They run, they walk. But raptors were different. Here is the foot of a raptor. I don't know if you can see it, but there's a big difference between these two toes. Ah, this one has one toe that's pointing up. You see, raptors only walk on two. They have five. One, two, three, four, five. But they only walk on two. They do not let this toe touch the ground because this toe is the one they use to cut their food. And they want it to be sharp. If it touches the ground, it could get broken. They cut their food with their foot. How'd you like to cut your food with your foot? Can you imagine if you woke up one morning and walked in the kitchen and your mom was making you breakfast? She's like, good morning. Here you go. Why did you kill my pancakes? Can you imagine if you cut your food with your foot? You'd be at a nice restaurant and right in the middle of the meal, you're like, Mom, Dad, allow me to demonstrate how a raptor cuts his food. Then you reach under the table and you take off your shoes and socks. And then you jump on the table and go. Your parents will be so happy. Your mom will sit there.
You are the smartest kid in the world.
And your dad will get up. Try to bring a little science in this family. What does it get you out of? There were all kinds of raptors, but one of them lived right here in Texas. How many of you have ever been to Texas? Oh, yeah, I forgot about that part. His name is Dinonychus. Can you say it? Now, he's bigger, and he's faster, and he's very naughty. He's got teeth that lean backwards. They lean backwards. That means that when he grabs something, you cannot get away. Look, I could put my hand in his mouth easily. Would it come out very easily? Let's try it. Hand goes in, no problem. Hand comes out, no problem. Hand comes out, no problem. There. Ah! Oh. Now people ask me all the time, if these were still alive, if they were still alive, is there any way we could get away from them? There is one way. I need a boy volunteer that wants to come up here and help me. Green shirt, come around this way, little man. Come down here. Walk around that side. Attaboy, come on up here. You're going to be perfect. I'll help you up. Make sure to be very careful coming up these stairs, okay? Come on up, big guy. This is going to be cool. You guys are going to be amazed at this. Come on up. What is your name?
Parker.
Parker, it's a pleasure to meet you, Parker. Here, come over here away from the edge. Attaboy, Parker. All right, let's go over here. I'm going to show you guys something cool. Parker, first you hold him since you're my assistant. You can hold him. For this to work, you guys have to be quiet. This is kind of cool. About the last 5 or 6 years, Parker, we've been studying. We've been studying how young boys like you, young men that are built, and then we study them, and we finally figured out how could somebody like you stop him if you didn't have any weapons? And this actually works. All right, here's what we're going to do, Parker. You're going to turn and face me, and of course nothing's going to happen to you. Parker, I'm going to act like he walks up. When I say go, I want you to take this arm. Okay. Parker, I want you to throw your arm in the air like I just did.
Okay.
Turn your head and look up at your hand and freeze. Don't look at anything in the room. Only look at your hand, okay? Let's practice. Parker, ready? Go. Attaboy. Don't move. Stay perfect. Parker, you're going to be perfect. You're going to be perfect. This is how Parker would be able to stop, and this actually works, how he could stop this dinosaur. Okay. He's walking along, Parker, and he spots you. He comes in. Ready? Go. Don't move. You killed it. Give him a hand, everybody. You are awesome. Here, we'll go. Attaboy, Parker. Have a good summer, buddy. Thank you so much. Be careful going down, all right? Attaboy. Attaboy. Your new name is Parker the Raptor Killer. Now, if you guys are standing somewhere and somebody goes, look, there's a dinosaur, Parker. I'll get him. I don't care. Now, these guys are fast, but there was a giant member of the raptor family. Its name was Utah Raptor. Can you say it?
Utah Raptor!
Here is his foot. If any of you saw Jurassic World, how many of you saw it? If you saw the movie Jurassic World, that movie, those dinosaurs that they called Velociraptor, in real life, Velociraptors are very tiny dinosaurs. This is the head of a full-grown Velociraptor.
All they did in the movie is they took a Utah raptor and called it Velociraptor in the movie. But in the movie, it's actually Utah raptor. They just think Velociraptor sounded like a cooler name. But Velociraptor is nowhere near the size of Utah raptor. And this is a big dinosaur, and that's a big claw. But it's not the biggest claw ever found. The biggest claw ever found on Earth was this thing. This is the fingernail of a dinosaur named Therizinosaurus. Can you say it?
Therizinosaurus.
Its fingernail is so giant. Girls, how'd you like nails like that? Ooh la la, look at my nails, everybody. Girls, if you had nails like this, you could give the boys free haircuts. Girls, if you had nails like this, you could give your dad a shave. Girls, if you had nails like this, you could be sitting at home at night watching TV, and your dad would come home kind of grumpy, and he'd be like, hey, turn off that TV and go to bed. You could look at your dad and say, I don't want to go to bed right now. And boys, if we had nails like this, we'd probably just pick our nose with it. Why are boys always picking their noses? My mom used to say that. Why do you always pick your nose? I'm like, Mom, the reason why I pick my nose, because I'm a boy. Boys are explorers. These are caves. Maybe a leprechaun left something in there. I don't know. All right. Here's the last dinosaur I'm going to tell you about. He is called the King of the Dinosaurs. His name starts with a letter T. His last name is Rex. It's Allosaurus. No, it's T-Rex. Tyrannosaurus Rex was a monster. You are talking about a dinosaur that if it was up on the stage with me, it would be longer than from that wall to this wall. His head would be as high as those lights above me. If a T-Rex walked in this auditorium right now, it would walk in, it would stop, it would look at all you kids and think, look at that, chicken nuggets. And I'd be down there with you just going, woohoo! 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 Go! When they're little, they're very, very cute. Here is the head of a little baby T-Rex. Isn't he cute? He would be cute for about a week. Can you imagine your mom and dad give you a live baby T-Rex and you look at them, you're like, Mom, Dad, this is the greatest gift ever. And then 1 week later, you walk up to them, Mom, Dad, it bit me. This is the worst gift ever. Then the next week, Mom, Dad, it ain't my hamster. This is the worst gift ever. And then the next week, Mom, Dad, it ain't my brother. This is the greatest gift ever. When he's little, he's kind of cute, but when it's full grown, those teeth are ginormous. Here is the jaw of a full grown T-Rex. Look at the size of the chompers on this dinosaur. This thing is massive. It is so big, it could bite off and swallow 500 pounds of meat in every bite. That means this dinosaur could fit 2,000 McDonald's hamburgers in its mouth at one time. The only animal on Earth that can do that today is an 18-year-old boy. Can you imagine if you were in McDonald's placing an order and a T-Rex walked in line next to you, you're like, ha, ha, ha. He looks at you, what's up? The guy behind the counter, can I take your order? Yeah, give me 80,000 hamburgers. Give me 25,000 orders of fries and a small diet soda. You want to know what I would do if a T-Rex actually walked in this room right now? Here's what I would do.
I would go out the side of the stage. There's a back entrance. I would go out. I would run across the parking lot. I would get in my truck. I'd drive back to San Antonio. I'd go to my house. I would run upstairs. I would grab my phone. I would crawl into my bed, and I would call for help because I am a hero.
All right, repeat after me. Today, we met a hero. Chicken? Who said chicken? Which one of you called me a chicken? You? All right, we're going to try that again. I better not hear chicken at anybody in this room. All right, here we go. And I better not hear chicken at anyone here. I am a hero, I'm not a chicken. All right, here we go. Today, we met a hero.
You rotten kids.
All right, listen, you guys. You guys are always, always one of the most polite and fun audiences I love. In fact, this is kind of winding down the summer reading tour, and we always sort of end with you guys. So it has been a pleasure coming up here every year and speaking to you. You guys have been great. You kids did an incredible job. Kids, raise your right hand and reach around and pat yourself on the back and say, I did good. I did good. Now look at the person beside you and say, so did you. Now look at the other person and say, you too. Now look at your parents and say, sorry, we drive you nuts. See, you think your mom and dad are normal. You know what happens when you kids go to bed? Your mom and dad just sit in the house and shake like chihuahuas. They just sit at the table going, what were we thinking with these cats? You, and I know you kids are in your room listening going,
mission accomplished.
Dear diary, today I made my mom just sit there and cry. You guys have been great. Have a great summer, everybody. Thank you. And thank you for supporting the library. Thank you guys so very much. We'll see you next year, okay? Bye-bye, guys. Be good, everybody. Be good. Be good. Bye-bye, everybody.